We are in Deir Mar Musa, the monastery of St. Moses, El Habashi, the Ethiopian or the Abyssinian. This is an old monastery in the desert of Syria, 100 kilometers northeast of Damascus. Before, down in that valley, caravans were passing from the third millennium before Christ, and in the time of the Roman Empire, there was here a little tower to watch the movements in the valley. The monastery went empty in the second half of the 18th century. The place ruined slowly, slowly. In the 80s of the last century, this went melting, with my own personal story. My name is Paolo Dall'Oglio in Arabic. Bulos, Abuna Bulos, Father Bulos. Came here for 10 days of prayer and I'm still there.
It's a place that's separate from the rest of the world in a very important way and very marked way, but at the same time it puts you together with all the other people who want to be away from the rest of the world.
I see my old picture, my old life. I'm not so happy. I'm happy here more.
The first Friday, there were so many people. So many people coming, you know. I felt like running away.
There must be some kind of way out of here. Say the joker to the thief. There's too much confusion. I can't get no relief. Businessman there, drink my wine. Plowman, dig my earth.
Excuse me?
No.
No dishes?
Yes.
Before?
Yes.
The prayer?
Okay.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Yes.
We are not a youth hostel, we are really a monastery.
No reason to get excited. The thief in kindness mode.
about toilets, the most essential breach in this convent. If when you go inside, you feel dirt and you make more dirt, then the world will be lost. But when you go inside, you feel dirt and you clean, and you go out feeling that the world has a hope, then hope of the world starts in the toilets. And hope of the world ends in the toilets.
Because sometimes maybe we are afraid of somebody that we don't know. So the idea to know more the other is one of the main ideas we would like also to present for Christian and Muslim youth.
It's a golden opportunity here to reflect on the whole purpose of monasteries and why they've ever existed and why we need to constantly in our life reevaluate where we are.
We will inevitably spoil the thing we come to see.